Hello, my name is Kent. In this video, we'll look at how to control LinuxCNC using an external program. I frequently need a motorized stage for prototyping and taking measurements. A CNC mill provides a rigid and accurate platform on which to prototype ideas before designing a specialized stage. Using the LinuxCNC Python module, we can command LinuxCNC in ways not practical with G-code alone. While unlikely to be part of a fast servo control loop, the method could be used to coordinate measurements, analysis, and then command additional machining. As a demonstration, we'll move a Fluxgate magnetometer in a rectilinear pattern and measure the magnetic flux lines about a magnet. As an example of machining feedback, perhaps this could be used to measure and reshape a magnet. We'll first examine the program, then conduct a demo, and then look at the graphs of the collected data. This is the program that will use to control LinuxCNC and to take measurements. It's available from my GitHub repository if you'd like to download it. The program is written in Python, and Python makes it really easy to prototype applications like this. The first portion of the program is simply documentation. The next portion is the importation of various modules. The first three are system modules, while the next two are third-party modules. The LinuxCNC module should come with LinuxCNC, but this VXI-11 module is a third-party one that I installed. The VXI-11 module is for controlling LXI-enabled network instruments. Next, we come to the argument parsing code. For each of the three axes, we must specify a start position, an end position, and a displacement or step size. All the arguments are read from the command line and converted to floating point numbers. Next, we establish a connection to an already running LinuxCNC instance. The first connection is so that we can query LinuxCNC state, while the second connection is so that we can command LinuxCNC. Next, we have two function definitions. The purpose of these functions is to verify that LinuxCNC is in a state that is able to accept MDI commands. MDI stands for manual data input, and you can think of this as G-code on a command line. The functions first pull LinuxCNC state and then verify that for each of the axes that's enabled that it is also homed. If the e-stop is triggered, if the machine isn't home, isn't enabled, or LinuxCNC is not in a state that is able to accept input, this function will return false. If this function returns false, then the verify OK for MDI will exit the program. We now command LinuxCNC to enter MDI mode so that we can send it G-code commands. We wait for this operation to complete before continuing. Next, we'll define a function that, given an XYZ position, will construct a G-code command that will move the mill to that given position. Notice that we're using a G54 coordinate system, so the assumption is the mill has been homed and the probe in this case has been touched off. We verify that the mill is in a state that it's able to accept MDI commands, and then we send this G-code command to the mill. We'll wait up to 60 seconds for the G-code command to complete. If it doesn't complete within that time, an error message is printed and the program is exited. Next, we establish a connection to the instrument that we'll be using for taking the measurements. We're using the VXI-11 module, and we're making a connection to a network-enabled multimeter. We first make the connection to the multimeter and then ask the multimeter for its identity. We verify the returned identity against the expected identity, and if they don't match, we exit the program. The multimeter is reset to a factory default state and then configured for taking auto-ranging DC measurements. We define a helper function for taking three readings from the multimeter with a small delay between each of the measurements. We define a helper function for taking three measurements from the multimeter with a small delay between each of the measurements. These measurements can be used to compute statistics. Now we define a helper function for constructing grids in a zigzag rectilinear pattern. It makes more sense when you see this plotted. This method will minimize motion. This function is recursive and can accept an arbitrary number of axes. To make the main function easier to use, this is the interface function. We simply need to pass a tuple of start positions, end positions, and step sizes. All of the necessary temporary variables are built for us before calling the main function to construct the grid points. The arguments are slightly rearranged, separating out all of the start, end, and step size values. From those tuples, the grid points are generated. and for each of the points within the grid points, the XYZ value is extracted. CNC is commanded to move to that position. A small settling time is introduced in order for any vibration to subside, and then we sample from the probe. A timestamp is created and a result is written. We immediately flush the output so that we can write these results into a file and we can see the results as they are generated. For those who may be interested in alternative ways to construct these grid points, the simple method is to use three nested for loops. The disadvantage of this is that you're limited to the number of dimensions as you have for loops, and the code is a mess, especially if you want to do this rectilinear method where you have no zigzags. Another method would be to construct the list using some Python methods. This is slightly nicer, but you still have the issue with only having as many dimensions as you have for loops. The recursive method is the superior method. It allows for an arbitrary number of axes, and the code is really pretty simple. It takes a little bit more to perhaps understand, but if you print out some intermediate values, you quickly understand how this works. That's the end of the code examination. Let's get to the mill and watch this program run. We have a CNC mill with a Fluxgate magnetometer double-sided taped to the side of the head. And a magnet below it mounted in a wooden base so it doesn't distort the magnetic fields. And we're going to scan the area around this magnet by moving the table and the head. On top here, we have a C-clamp that's just holding the cable in place. It's not holding the spindle. The spindle's locked in case the spindle would turn on, that we wouldn't damage anything below. Spindle motor would just fault because it wouldn't be able to turn. This is the control box for the Fluxgate magnetometer. And then that is attached to a multimeter, which is networked operated. Then I have a LinuxCNC controlling the mill and a command line where we will run our program. Just to give you a reminder, this is the program that we were just looking at. And I'll execute it with these parameters. So I'll start the zero position on X, go to 1.5 and 0.5 increments, negative 0.75 on Y, up to positive 0.75 and 0.5 increments, and 0 to 1.5 on Z and 0.5 increments. Here we can see in LinuxCNC that the mill is starting to move. And we'll just clear this pattern out. Come here and look at the mill. See that it is indeed moving. And you could move the mill quite a bit faster than this. I was using 5 inches per minute as a conservative number in case something did go wrong, that there would be minimal damage. You see the command that's being sent to LinuxCNC, and then the result that comes back from the multimeter. Took 3 readings, about 1.65, and here they are collected by the program. So I think this is really a very powerful tool for adding information into LinuxCNC from external sensors. in addition to just using LinuxCNC and a mill for prototyping instruments? Well, this video is about controlling LinuxCNC using an external program for prototyping and not about magnets, I do want to show you briefly data from our example. This is a neodymium magnet inserted into a piece of brass with the upward facing pole stamped on the back. Using MagnetView film, we can verify that there is a single pole facing upward and that the north and south poles appear no different under MagnetView film. Because the Fluxgate magnetometer is only measuring the magnetic flux through the plane of the probe tip, not the direction of the flux, the graph of our data shows a mountain and a deep valley corresponding to when the probe was in front of and behind of the center line of the magnet respectively. To get a more familiar graph of the lines of flux, we would have to rotate the Fluxgate magnetometer about the center axis of the magnet. Because of symmetry in the lines of flux of this magnet, there is no change in the graph when the magnet is rotated. This is a regular refrigerator magnet. While not as strong as the neodymium magnet, the lines of flux from this magnet are much more interesting. This sort of magnet is called a Hallbach array. The magnet is composed of alternating poles, and the poles are arranged in such a way that the strength of the magnet is nearly double on one side and nearly zero on the other side. This results in more interesting measurements. And rotating this type of magnet certainly does change the graph, and shows the ability of the Fluxgate magnetometer to differentiate lines of flux that are not perpendicular to the tip. Because this Fluxgate magnetometer is sensitive to fields weaker than the Earth's magnetic field, we have to first check that our environment has a consistent magnetic field, which it does. The Python LinuxCNC module allows one to quickly control a sophisticated and rigid multi-axis system for purposes other than the CNC machine was originally designed. For prototyping machines like scientific instruments, repurposing a CNC machine could save a great deal of expense while proving out the idea. Instead of static G-code, a program can record or change parameters on the fly, such as in control systems. If anyone knows of or develops other applications using external control of LinuxCNC, please send me a message. I would really enjoy hearing about your application. Thank you for watching, and I hope you'll be back for the next video.